Sup, Nerd Migos? I'm the Jive Talking Nerd, John Norgrove, and this is Nerd Jive. We're back from a little bit of a break, and I don't fucking care to deal with that shit. That's on you guys. So, first up is the weather.
It's cold as shit out here today.
And, the weather today is brought to you by the fact that it was beautiful earlier, but still freezing cold, and I forgot to do the weather, and then when I did the weather, it wasn't as beautiful, but equally freezing cold, so I don't know how to feel about that. Apparently, it was warm where I live, just cold where I work. So that's great. Anywho, let's get on to the news. So first up, the good. Black Mirror is getting a season 5, which is fire. Oh my god, Black Mirror is so good. So good. Anywho, Black Mirror is getting a season 5. The announcement was just made, or recently made, or bloody whatever. You know how the internet works. Everything's kind of temporarily out of phase. But this is super great news, and season 4 was super, super awesome. All right, so let's do a quick talk on season 4. First up, the Star Trek episode, which is the first episode, the USS McAllister or something like that. USS Callister, I don't remember exactly what the name of the episode is. Best episode of this season, hands down, no questions asked. It was so good. All right, that being said, the season closer, which is called Black Museum, which is the museum episode, obviously, is so, oh my god, it was such an amazing episode. I mean, there were some, the robot dog episode, not that great. The second episode, which is the one with the mom and the, like, Archangel is the name of the episode, that's freaky deaky. That episode just creeped me the shit out. Like, the whole episode, I'm just like, yeah, the Star Trek episode was absolutely amazing. Super, super good. And the Black Museum episode was really just, it was so dark. It was so dark and just like freaky. Like, if you put yourself in the place of some of those people that are, like, trapped inside of, like, eternally trapped inside of this, like, digital, like, hell, like, void. Oh, man. So dark. But, yeah, I love this season. I've liked all the seasons. This season was not their best season, but definitely a strong season. The opener and closers were both very, very strong. If you want us, wife and I, to do reviews for, like, shows like, oh, let's do reviews of Black Mirror, like, something a bit more long form, let me know in the comments below. If you've seen Black Mirror Season 4, let me know what you think about each one of the episodes. Full spoilers, man, it's been enough time. People need to cool their tits with that shit. But, let me know below and see what's up. I would love to just start doing some more long form review stuff, but I don't know if it really, like, who's into it? What's up? So, whatever. Anywho, next up is The Bad, and it's the 2018 Academy Awards. Not that they're bad, or that something bad happened in them, although both may be entirely plausible. Bad because I don't fucking care about award shows, especially Hollywood wanking itself off award shows, which is what the Academy Awards and the Oscars and all this other shit is. Just a bloody waste of time. Who cares? Half of those, like, awarded movies or critically acclaimed movies or anything suck anyway. I don't want to watch those. Like, blah. So, but, this is popular, and so I decided to talk about it because I need something bad. And there really wasn't that much badness in this realm. You know, we try to steer clear of the politics and the sadness and all that kind of stuff. So let's, smile badness. Let's get into the people that won, or the stuff that won that I care about. First up, Gary Oldman won Best Actor. 100%, he always deserves it. Gary Oldman is phenomenal. It actually came up at work, specifically Gary Oldman winning Best Actor, like 5 times in conversation, even though people that I work with know that I'm really not, like, a award show person. But it always came up with, like, hey, you know Gary Oldman from The Fifth Element? He won an award. And I'm like, it's funny that you say that. I love The Fifth Element and Gary Oldman. And we're cosplaying The Fifth Element this year at Fanime. So, one of our friends is cosplaying as Gary Oldman's character, which is Zorg. So, yeah, look forward to that shit. It's gonna be tight. Next up, Sam Rockwell won Best Supporting Actor. Again, phenomenal actor. Sam Rockwell is such a great actor. I want him to have more roles. He's amazing. Good on you. Shape of Water got Best Picture, which is directed by Guillermo del Toro. I have not seen Shape of Water yet, but I've only heard great things from every person I've talked to about it, and I do want to see it. I just kind of, like, missed the wagon on that one. More Guillermo del Toro. The guy's deep weird, and I love it. More deep weird in the world. And then lastly, Jordan Peele won Best Original Screenplay for Get Out. Which, again, I have not seen Get Out. I have read and seen all of the stuff about it. That just came out at, like, an awful time for me, like, timing-wise. So I didn't get a chance to see it. So I'm still waiting to be able to have a chance to see that. But I've seen some pretty in-depth breakdowns of the film and the story. And you know what? Based on the stuff that I've seen and read, he 100% deserves it. Also, Jordan Peele is an amazing guy. I mean, solid films, or, you know, this is a solid film. His comedy's gold, you know, it's just, he deserves this kind of stuff. Also, I think maybe he might be the first black guy to have, I read, like, there are articles linked below, and I skimmed them, but boy, I don't fucking care about Hollywood at all. Like, seriously. But, like, I think he's, like, maybe the first black guy to ever win Best Screenplay or something. So either way, there was some award set in that, and there, I know there was some drama about it. I think Philip DeFranco talked about it or something, but whatever, dude, it's award shows. Like, you're a more special millionaire than us other millionaires, blah. So I don't fucking care. Lastly is the gaming. So we've had the good, we've had the bad, now we have the gaming, and I have to talk about Into the Breach. It is so amazing. I bought it on Friday. I have literally played it all weekend. It is amazing. Amazing, amazing, amazing. Okay, so it's brought to us by the same motherfuckers that brought to us FTL, which, as you know, if you see my live streams on Twitch, that's like one of my favorite games of all time. I love FTL. It's just, it's so good and has good music and good graphics and good gameplay, and it's fucking intensely hard, and it's just fun. It's just a good fucking game. And Into the Breach is the same thing. They brought us fire second time. Lightning struck twice in the same place with these motherfuckers. It is super, super good. So it's essentially like mechs versus giant bugs. I wrote this down. It's like it's a turn-based action RPG with a time travel twist is the best way I could try to explain it. I don't traditionally like turn-based combat, but this, you kind of don't, you think about the turn-based and all that kind of stuff, but there's so much shit for you to pay attention to and remember, because you can take damage. You have buildings that you're trying to protect. Each one of your mechs has different features and functions and weapons and movements, and each one of the enemies has different features and functions and weapons and movements, and the grids are very, very small by relative comparison to the things in them, and so you have so much to work with and such a small amount of time. I mean, you know, these rounds are like 8 rounds or 6 rounds or something like that, like turns. Like, you only get like 6 to 8 turns, and if you can keep everything stable and alive for that long, then you win. You know, or if you'd like, you know, whatever, defeat all the bugs and stuff. So it's just really good. It's really in depth. Each one of the worlds is like 4 worlds, like 4 islands within the world. Each one's totally different. You know, and there's all these, like, there's like a million ways to do a single task, and they do a great job with it. It's absolutely amazing. It's another, just, it's so hard. Oh my god, this game is so hard. I've yet to beat it, although, at about 6 or 7 o'clock last night, I came, like, one turn. I was one goddamn turn away from beating the game, and there were too many bugs on the screen, and I had everything in position. I was like ready to rock and roll, and, you know, the bug turn, and then my turn came, and it's just like, I only had 2, like, points left of life, of energy, and I could not stop enough bugs to not cause 2 points of energy. And if I had been able to do that, if I had been able to make it only 1 point of lost energy, then I would have won. I was like that close. I was so pissed. I literally like turned off my computers, shut it down. I'm done for the night. So yeah, there's that. But anyway, that's the good, the bad, and the gaming. Buy Into the Breach. If you've played it, comment below. Let me know. Like, what do you think? So tomorrow is Tuesday. I'm back on it. Tuesdays and Thursdays, I'm live streaming. This week, Into the Breach, all week. It's an Into the Breach week. Fucking deal with that shit. Watch me play. It's going to be amazing. It's twitch.tv/nerdjive. You're going to love it. It's a great game. And, like, the whole time, I'm just going to be talking strategy and yelling at my computer and at bugs, which is great. Also, don't forget to like this video. Comment below. Let me know what you think about the Oscars. Let me know what you think about this video game. Let me know what you think about that. First thing I talked about is that my mind is slipping on because I'm super tired. I think there's a SpaceX launch tonight also, so if you watch that, let me know what you think about that, because I'm going to be watching it tonight also. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. We're growing. We're slow, but we're making moves. Let's make moves. If you're subscribed already, talk to some other motherfuckers. Get those motherfuckers subscribed. It's awesome. Anywho, like, comment, share, subscribe. Yeah, share. That's the other one. Don't forget to share this video and other videos similar to this one. I've been John Norgrove. This has been Nerd Jive. And I will catch you guys later. Stay nerdy, folks.